Okay, so continue tayo. So sa previous na video, na-compute na natin yung Venus Fix. So this time, compute natin to. Paano naman pag yung Venus, nag-move siya 6 meter per second in same direction as the jet. So, compute natin to. So bali dito, nag-move yung jet natin at this direction. Diba? So yung vane din natin is moving in the same direction. So let's say velocity ng jet is, meters per second, and then yung velocity ng vane natin is, ito na, dito pala, 6 meter per second. So ibig sabihin yung relative velocity nila is 9 meters per second. So ibig sabihin yung V1 relative, di ba, yung dito, kung ito yung point 1 natin, and then ito yung point 2. So meron tayong V1 relative tsaka V2 relative. So lahat yan equals to yung relative, 9 meters per second. V2 relative is also 9 meters per second. So I hope klaro tayo dyan, huh? So ngayon, kukunin natin yung component ng mga relative. So unahin ko muna yun dito. So makikita natin dito na yung V1x is equivalent to V1 relative. So V1x is also V1 relative. So that is just 9 meters per second. And then yung V1y, which is supposedly dito. So since yung V1 relative is horizontal, so expected yung V1y is just equal to 0. So this one is 0. And then yung V2 dito, yung V2x is just equal to, kung ito siya 60 degrees, so this one is 60 degrees. So this is V2 relative cosine 60. So V2x is just equal to 9 cosine 60. And for y, which is ito yan, so we have V2y. So V2y is just equal to V2 relative sine 60. So we have V2y that is equal to 9 sine 60. Okay, so pwede natin i-plug in yan sa formula, no? So bali dito, meron na tayong Q at DX is equivalent to Q unit weight ng liquid over gravity, V1x minus V2x. Lahat yan relative yung velocity dito. So we have Q. Kumpitin ko muna yung Q. So makikita natin dito na yung Q is just area times velocity na relative. So meron tayong area, pi over 4 nung 0.05 squared, kasi yung cross section ng jet natin is 50 mm yung diameter. And then, yung relative natin dito is 9 meters. 9 meters per second. So, yung Q natin is just equal to, okay, compute muna natin. Shift pi over 4 times 0.05 squared times 9. So, meron na tayong 0.018 cubic meter per second. So, meron na tayong 0.018. And then, meron tayong 9, 8, 10. all over yung gravity natin na 9.81. So expected Newton yung sagot ko dito kasi 9810 Newton per cubic meter yan. No. And then yung V1x natin is ito, 9. And then yung V2x natin is 9 minus, so 9 cosine 60. And for the dy, so palitan lang natin yung x by y. So we have q unit weight ng liquid over gravity. Ito is v1y minus v2y. So lahat to relative, no? So yung dy is meron na tayong 0.018 ng 9810 all over 9.81. And then, yung V1y natin is, meron tayong V1y, 0. So, we have 0 minus yung V2y natin na 9 sine 60. Okay, so, masasolve na natin ito. Ilang kaya ito? So, we have 0.018 times 9810 all over 9.81. Times we have 9 minus 9 cosine 60. Okay, so meron na tayong 81 Newton. We have 81 Newton. And then compute natin yung with respect to y. So meron tayong, so palitan ko lang to ng sine, and then ito palitan ko ng 0. So I have negative 140.3. Okay? So, negative 140.3 Newton. So, ito na yung sagot for the dx. And ito na yung sagot for the dy. So, yung dynamic force natin is just square root lang nung dx squared plus yung dy squared. So, we have square root nung 81 squared plus yung negative 140.3 squared. Okay? So, meron na tayong dynamic force which is equivalent to square root lang nung 81 squared plus negative 140.3 squared. Okay? So, we have 162. Okay? So, yun na yung sagot. So, I hope klaro tayo dyan. So, that's it. Okay? Okay, so sa next na problem is compute natin, what if yung vane is moving at 6 meter per second in opposite direction as the jet, and while yung vane is deflected 150 degrees with respect to x-axis. So again, meron tayong velocity ng jet, ito yan. Yung direction ng velocity ng jet. And then, yung vane natin is moving in opposite direction. So, bali ito. And is moving in opposite direction. Okay, so we use plus, no? In solving for the relative. So, yung velocity ng jet natin is meron tayong 15 meters per second. And then, yung sa vane natin is 6 meter per second. So, yung relative, since opposite yung direction nila, so, mag plus tayo, no? So, 15 plus 6, that is 21 meters per second. So, dito kasi is same yung direction nila. So, kaya mag ma-minus yan, no? Yan dito. So, magma-minus yan. 15 minus 6, so that is 9. Okay? Pag, ano, hindi ko pala nasabi, ano? So, anyway, magma-minus yan. Pagdating mo dito, pag opposite yung direction nila, is mag-a-add ka lang. So, magpa-plus ka. Okay, so I think okay na tayo sa V1 relatives. Ito yung V, if I assume this is my point 1. Then I assume this is my point 2. So, bali, meron din ako ditong V2 relative and V1 relative, which is equivalent to 21 meters per second. And then dito naman is 21 meters per second. Okay, so compute natin yung mga component ng velocity. So, meron tayong V1x. So, we have V1x. Dito. So, yung V1x is equivalent to V1 relative, and that is 21 meters per second. While yung V1y is just equivalent to 0, no? Kasi wala siyang vertical. So, dito naman. So, yung V2x natin is just equal to V2 relative cosine yung angle na, which is 30 degrees. And take note, may sign convention kasi yung velocity dito na. So ibig sabihin, yung velocity is positive pag ganito, di ba? Ito positive daw, no? So we take as positive. And then pag opposite na sign, so opposite na direction, so negative siya. So magdadagdag lang ako ng negative na sign dito. So, bali yung V2x ko ngayon is just equal to negative 21 cosine 30. Okay. So, ngayon, kunin natin yung V2y. So, which is yung ito yan. So, again, positive pag upward, negative pag downward. So, since positive siya, upward, so positive lang nung V2 relative cosine, sine, rather, sine 30. So, meron na tayong V2y, which is 21, positive 21 sine 30. So, ayoko klaro na tayo dyan. So, pwede natin i-plug in yan ngayon sa formula for the dynamic force. So, we have now dx, that is q unit weight ng liquid over gravity, v1x minus v2x. So, yung flow rate natin, computing ko muna, I have area times velocity relative. So, yung area is, again, this is 50 mm diameter. So, meron akong pi over 4. Nung 0.05 squared. And then yung relative velocity natin is 21. So meron na tayong flow rate, and that is just equal to shift pi over 4 times 0.05 squared times 21. So meron tayong 0.04 cubic meter per second. 0.04 cubic meter per second. So, plug in ko na yan. Ha? So, bali meron akong ditong 0.04 times 9.810 all over gravity na 9.81. So, yung V1x natin is 21 minus yung V2x natin, which is negative 21 cosine 30. And then for the dy, so meron tayong q unit weight ng liquid over gravity, and then we have v1y minus v2y. So subset na lang pa rin natin yung mga values. We have 0.04 nung 9.810 all over 9.81, and then yung v1y natin is 0, and then yung v2y natin is 21, positive 21, sine 30. Okay, so makukuha na natin yung value, and then makukuha na din natin yung dynamic force, which is dx squared plus dy squared. Sige, computing ko muna. So I have 0.04 times 9.8, 10 all over 9.81 times. I have 21 minus negative 21 cosine 30. So yan yung sagot. I have 1567.46 Newton. And then dito naman, so papalitan lang natin to ng sine, and then tanggalin natin positive sine, and then ito magiging 0. So we have negative 420 Newton. So yung sine dyan ha is convention lang kung saan nag-move yung direction ng dynamic force. So anyway, lagay ko na lang negative 420 Newton. So ngayon, meron na tayong square root ng 1567.46 squared plus yung negative 420 squared. So we have now the value for the dynamic force, and it's just equal to square root lang ng 1567.46 squared plus 420 squared. So we have 1622.754 Newton. So yan, no? So ito na yung mga sagot. Okay, so that's it, and see you in the next video. Thank you.